everybody, this is Jeff from Reverb.com. And today I want to talk a little bit about the guitar playing of the late great blues man, Mr. Lightnin' Hopkins, another Texas blues guitar player. Primarily known as an acoustic player, he used a Gibson J160, and in his later years installed a pickup in it and kind of got a half acoustic, half electric kind of sound. So I'm kind of demonstrating the licks here on a Ron Emery Fender Parlor acoustic that we had here at Reverb. But I'd like to mention, you know, some of these licks I'm going to show you are also very adaptable to the electric guitar, because Lightnin' Hopkins had a tendency to play more single note lines than a lot of other acoustic players, which adapts great to electric, and you can hear that, how he influenced a lot of electric players. A lot of Lightnin' Hopkins' material was based on 12 bars, so I'm kind of incorporating these concepts into a 12-bar blues. But one of the key things I like to talk about is the way he kind of played with his thumb. He used a thumb pick. I'm just using my bare thumb today, and his index finger. But you know, something typical of Lightnin' Hopkins would be something like, sometimes he would have the thumb going more constantly. Sometimes he would let the note kind of ring out. But he did a brushing technique, and I'm right here in the key of E, like E pentatonic. And he would brush, he would let more than one string kind of ring together. See, I'm kind of striking the E string and holding this formation, fourth fret on the G string, my middle finger, index finger on the third fret of the B string, and then hitting the high E as well. Sliding back to second, down to two. And he would follow that up, you know, with a number of different single note lines. So that would be very reminiscent of something Lightnin' Hopkins would do. A lot of these other cool single note lines you can hear later on in other blues guys like Stevie Ray Vaughan, Johnny Winter, all kinds of people. But one that comes to mind that I think comes from the Lightnin' repertoire would be. Here I'm using the blue note here. I'm right on the blues scale using my index finger. That's a really cool one. Starting at the seventh fret, just going down chromatically, 7-6-5 on the high E. Jumping down to the third fret here, open E, and then off the third fret of the B string, the open E between it. And he has a tendency to tag stuff with that open E. In fact, another cool thing about what I love about Lightnin' Hopkins' 12-bar blues, after you've gone to the 5 chord, back to the 4 chord, and you're getting ready to turn around, a lot of times he doesn't turn around like, you know, like a typical blues. A typical blues might go. But Lightnin' Hopkins would do something more like from the 5. And then just start over. He had a tendency to stay on the 1, which I always thought was a cool little transition. Lightnin' also had a tendency to move around up the neck. He would never stay down in one position. For effect, he would go up high and play more of those single note lines that I was talking about earlier. I'm at the 10th fret, sliding up to the 12th, again using my index finger, keeping my thumb to handle the low string duties. Going from 10 to 12, 10 on the B string, then going to the E string at 10, 12, 10, back to 12 on the B string, sliding back to 10, then 8 on the B string, 9 on the G string, back to 8 on the B string. You could do all kinds of variations with it. But he would throw those in the middle of a 12-bar blues. And then another thing you hear a lot of blues players do is this cool little, which is very lightning. Something you hear in a lot of his material. I'm at the 7th fret of the high E, 8th fret of the B string, kind of hitting the E at times, the low E at times, but giving a little shake, a little vibrato. So there's some cool and different ways that, you know, Lightnin' Hopkins approach the 12-bar blues. The really cool single note lines, again, that work, of course, on acoustic, but work just as well on an electric guitar. Even with a pick, too. I mean, there's a lot you can do with this stuff, so I hope that you can get some of these ideas and get them into your own playing. And check out some Lightnin' Hopkins recordings if you haven't already. Until next time.